5 overs to go. Now the scenario changes. It changes again. What a shot that is.
That's going away. Oh, I love it. I just can't believe it. We're right up here from our vantage point high up in the rafters. And I looked down and I went, that's gone. For 6, 48 of them have gone. It's 272 for 6. This has gone all the way for the maximum. Game on, folks.
And yeah, he was looking for that full length delivery, but as it turned out, it was just there in the slot for Kamran Akmal to play that shot. I don't think he was really looking to go over long off as much as going over the bowler's head. But then just got to slice it, but look at the distance that he's got.
That's a bit bigger than Kowloon at Hong Kong. That is a clean stroke. Like you say, Sanch, didn't even get quite all of it, and it still sailed comfortably over for 6.
10 runs to win. Here we go.
Oh!
This is unbelievable.
You're the world champion. That is another one. He is snatching this away from the West Indies. Shouldn't be happening. You've got to get the ball in the hole, and Taylor is not.
This is shocking. 2 consecutive sixes. And look at the man. He's just relaxed there as if nothing's happened. 2 glorious hits on the offside. 2 huge sixes on a big ground against a fast bowler. And now you're looking at 4 runs to win from 3 balls, Danny.
Well, I'm chucking him at your 50-50 call. And now you'd have to say it swung the other way with the favouritism, with the home side, with the bat in hand.
Well, Gerald Taylor's got to do something with his length, Danny.
Oh, absolutely. That's true there, just saying. Got to get a Yorker in right now.
Again, the length was just right there in the slot for Kamran Akmal. He's going to get 2 for this. Alam wanted the third, but good thinking by Kamran Akmal. Oh, can you believe that?
And it's all crazy here at Abu Dhabi. Now she's all tied up, folks. 1 to win with a misfield there. It's just fallen apart here from the West Indies. Good save out on the fence. And then he said, no, I'll take the strike. You stay there, Alan. I'll take the strike and finish the game. And then there, Taylor, who's having a shocker, can't even take that. Can't get the Yorker in, let alone hold onto the ball. And it is all happening out in the center.
Well, they've got it through the ring of fielders, and Pakistan have won this game.
Listen to the crowd. Look at the crowd going berserk here in Abu Dhabi. They've won it. They are heroes. Against all odds, really, with about 4 overs to go, you had to say the West Indies were in control.
It was mission impossible when Kamran Akmal came in. The last over set up, Jerome Taylor had bowled the earlier over. His earlier over in the spell, quite effectively. And your money was on West Indies. What happened there?
Well, simply didn't execute at the death. They started to fall apart, the West Indies, in the field, and particularly here with Jerome Taylor bowling 2 length balls to Kamran Akmal, who got underneath him and leveraged him over long off and then over cover. 2 stunning strokes.
West Indies getting 294. Chris Gayle notching up his 17th ODI 100, a half century to Ram Narasimhan as well. 3 wickets apiece for Sohail Tanvir and Umar Gul, who came back well towards the end. Half centuries for Manzoor and Malik, and that really established a good platform for Pakistan, for the West Indies. They'll take some pride in the fact that Lionel Baker picked up 3 wickets for 47 runs. Now,